Welcome to the STRIPE Stroke Interprofessional Education session. In this module, you will be learning about CT and CT angiograms in stroke. My name is Santosh Raj.
And my name is Carol Tham.
We will be bringing you through this module today.
The objectives of this module are to learn how to read a CT scan, to recognize common CT scan findings in ischemic and hemorrhagic strokes, and to recognize common CT angiogram findings.
The contents of this module cover the following topics on CT brain and CT angiography of the circle of Willis. This slide shows you the normal appearance of a CT brain at the level of the basal ganglia on your left and at the level of the cerebellum on your right. Soft tissue appears gray, with the white matter appearing slightly darker than the gray matter. CSF appears black. Bone and calcification appear white.
In the event of an acute ischemic stroke, you can sometimes see a dense MCA sign. In this example, there is a dense right middle cerebral artery. In this example, there is a hyperdense basilar artery.
Early ischemic changes in the brain parenchyma are demonstrated as swelling, evidenced by sulcal effacement and loss of gray-white matter differentiation. In this example, there is sulcal effacement and loss of gray-white matter differentiation in the left cerebral hemisphere. Of note, there is also loss of the insular ribbon. In this example of an acute ischemic stroke, there is loss of the right insular ribbon and obscuration of the right lentiform nucleus, compatible with a right middle cerebral artery territory infarct. In this example, we see loss of gray-white matter differentiation and swelling in the left frontal lobe, compatible with an acute left middle cerebral artery territory infarct. Do note, there is a hypodense area in the right caudate and lentiform nucleus region compatible with an old infarct as well.
In this example, there is a discrete wedge-shaped hypodense area in the left cerebral hemisphere. This is compatible with an established infarct in the left middle cerebral artery territory.
The ASPECTS score, or also known as the Alberta Stroke Program Early CT score, is a commonly used 10-point quantitative topographic score used in patients with middle cerebral artery stroke. Based on the regions involved, as shown in this slide, 1 point is deducted from an initial score of 10 for every region involved. The resulting score, if low, is a poor score, whereas if the score is high, then it is a good score.
An ischemic stroke can sometimes turn hemorrhagic. In this example, there is hemorrhagic conversion of the left MCA infarct.
Not all patients presenting with clinical symptoms of stroke have an underlying ischemic stroke. Some patients have hemorrhagic strokes. In this patient with uncontrolled hypertension, there is a left thalamic hemorrhage. Do note that hypertensive-related hemorrhages in the brain can occur in the basal ganglia, thalamus, pons, and cerebellum.
This example shows a left frontal hemorrhage that is not hypertension-related. In this case, other causes of the hemorrhage need to be searched for.
Another type of intracranial hemorrhage that can be seen in patients presenting with stroke is subarachnoid hemorrhage. In this example, we see diffuse subarachnoid hemorrhage associated with hydrocephalus due to a ruptured anterior communicating artery aneurysm.
Now, we move on to CT angiograms. This is an example of a normal CT angiogram showing the circle of Willis. We can see bilateral middle cerebral arteries directed horizontally. The anterior cerebral arteries are directed anteriorly and the posterior cerebral arteries are directed posteriorly.
In patients presenting with acute ischemic stroke, CTA of the circle of Willis is performed to identify patients that have large vessel occlusions who may benefit from thrombectomy. It is also useful to exclude any other stroke mimic. In this patient, we see an occlusion of the M1 segment of the left middle cerebral artery.
This example shows an occlusion of the distal internal carotid artery. There is also occlusion of the proximal anterior cerebral artery and the proximal middle cerebral artery on the right side. This is an example of a T-occlusion. The image in the middle is an angiographic image taken pre-thrombectomy, demonstrating the T-occlusion. The image on the right is an angiographic image taken post-thrombectomy demonstrating reperfusion.
Ischemic strokes can also occur in the posterior circulation. In this example, we demonstrate a top of the basilar occlusion.
In patients with ischemic strokes in the anterior circulation, it is important to look for stenosis in the carotid arteries. In this example, there is severe stenosis of the extracranial carotid artery.
Clinical features of stroke can be due to other underlying causes that can be a contraindication to the administration of IV thrombolysis. In this example, we show a large arteriovenous malformation in the left cerebral hemisphere. In this patient presenting as an acute ischemic stroke, CT angiogram of the circle of Willis demonstrates features suspicious for an underlying dural arteriovenous fistula. Subsequent angiography confirms the presence of an underlying dural arteriovenous fistula. Administration of IV thrombolysis in such patients can result in severe intracranial hemorrhage.
In summary, CT imaging is a useful tool to differentiate between ischemic and hemorrhagic strokes, and it should be performed in all acute stroke patients. CTA helps to identify patients with large vessel occlusion that may benefit from thrombectomy, and it also helps to exclude stroke mimics that need to be managed differently.
Thank you for joining us on this short journey in CT and CT angiography in stroke.
We hope that you have had a pleasant learning experience.